welcome to the show. This is Sherlock T with a Let's Build episode. So with no further ado, we're going to get right to it. So as you can see, we're on an ocean theme map here. I've got a bunch of different models that I've built. Some turtles, some statues there in the back, some dragonflies. There's an aquarium, a monkey head, which I'm also making monkeys half done over here. So what we got planned today is we're going to do a couple snails, and as you can see over here, I've got a couple built already. So just to give you an idea of what we're going to do, it's pretty easy to build these guys, you'll see. So if anybody's interested in making their own snails, you'll see it's not too difficult. It's all basic shapes mostly. These two here, you could actually ride. This is a snail mail truck. And a shark tank. And a tank. A shark tank tank. So, what you want to do generally, get down to the bottom of your hierarchy. We're going to want to build at 0-0. That way it makes mirroring nice and easy, and you'll see. I don't think we'll be mirroring too much on this model, but if you want to do, say, the shark here, you would do one fin and then you would just mirror it over to the other side. Same for the eyes, same for the mouth, and you know, that way you're cutting down your work to half. Alright, so we're going to start with a basic shape. What we're going to want here for the snail's body. So when it comes down to the hills, it's hill number 4. So we're going to slap that over here into the hierarchy. So up here you have your different... So translation is to move your object around the map. Rotation is to rotate it in whichever direction you have 3 axes is. And scale to make it bigger or smaller. So what we're going to want to put. And you could also, it shows you the short keys. And a lot of things in core, for you newbies out there, a lot of these things have shortcuts. And when you hover over it, it shows you C. It says C at the end there. So W, E, and R. So those are your shortcuts on your keyboard. So if ever you need to remind yourself, that's what you want to do there. Alright, so for starters, I think I'm going to want this snail a little bit shorter and a little bit taller. Right. Now, as you can see, we're here on our 0-0. Next, we're going to want to put probably do his eyeballs next. So you could either, both these work pretty good, both the lathe. I'll go with the lathe ball. So you could so I want this the other way around. I could rotate it, or I could just right click, mirror the object on the world space C. So that flips it upside down for me. Want this to be a little on the longer side. So now we're gonna wanna give him an eyeball, so I want to go grab a sphere. Now, this trick for eyeballs, I'm going to show you. you can use for a lot of different models. It's one of the easier ways to do eyeball, I find. So now, I'm going to click on my sphere here in the hierarchy, and you can either duplicate it or copy-paste. I copy-paste because I'm old school like that, so Control-C, Control-V. So now that gives me another sphere in my hierarchy. Now one trick you can do is, if you scroll down here in your properties, you have meshes, which is for your object, whatever object it is. And then the material is for your different materials when you'll put over it. So what we're gonna wanna do here is switch this mesh. So I'm gonna switch it to a half thin sphere. Now you can see instead of a full sphere, I got a half sphere. I'm gonna shorten it down a little bit. If you grab this white cube instead of one of the other cubes, it makes all the axes bigger. So I'm gonna get that just a little. And see, now he's got an eyelid. And what you can do is, we're gonna do the same thing, copy paste. Now we're gonna mirror this on the Z axis to flip it upside down. Eyelid on the bottom, so we're gonna shorten that. And we want it to be a little bit shorter than the top one, so and as you can see, I'm a bit a little quick on getting the dimensions, but you know, that comes with practice. And then it's about just eyeballing it to see what dimensions look good, you know. There's no given rule. Alright, so now I probably want to give him a pupil. So we're going to go lens. Lens or lens half, doesn't really matter. I usually use the half. If ever you're not sure which axis it is, you want to switch to your rotate, start rotating it. And if you want it straight, you know, you're going in intervals of 90, so we're going to go 90, since I know which direction I want right now. And then we're going to make the whole thing smaller. And you want to grab it by the white cube here, because you want the dimensions of the circle to stay the same. You don't want to weird floppy circle. And then we're gonna take a look at this from the side and see how close it is. Okay, so you wanna keep your shape of your circle so that it looks nice. Even if you're out a little bit off, I mean, you would have to be this close in order to see that this lens isn't quite on, right? So don't worry about that, you know, because when somebody's playing the game, you say they're standing right here on the map, right? They're gonna be looking at it, you know, from roughly this, from this distance right now. There's no way you're gonna see that little gap, so little things like that, don't fuss too much, and don't give yourself a hard time trying to get it perfect. So we're gonna grab everything, our whole eyeball here, so grab the bulb, and then we're gonna hold shift and click on the lens. That selects all five things here in the hierarchy. You can could also just say click on the ball and then hold shift and press down on the keyboard, but there's different ways you could do that. So now we're gonna copy all five of these, so either duplicate or control C, control V. Alright, so now we're gonna wanna make this into a merge model. Sorry about that break. Okay, so now we copied our eyeball and our eyeball stock, whatever you would call this. So we copied it into a merge model. Now we know exactly its position on the map, so what we're going to want to do is have it roughly the same side, same distance on the other side. So let's see how that looks. Alright, so now we're going to want to move on to his shell. So now there's obviously a bunch of different ways you can do this. You can choose just about any shape you want. Let's see. Yeah, because you could give them all types of funny shells, really. Grab this, moving on to the map. So I could unmerge this for now. And so you go to unwrap. Okay, now we're gonna rotate this over. Move it up a little. And one thing I suggest for everybody that's, new to using an engine like this, really take your time to get used to the controls and so E moves you up on the map, Q moves you down, and then A, W, D, and S are your other directions. And the more you can flow around the map using these buttons, the easier time. Okay, so we want to be on the zero of the X, right in the middle of the body. I want to widen this. Now, as you can see, this actually ends in there, but that doesn't really matter. Like, we want it to be hollow. The way people are going to see it, they're not going to be able to tell that it's not hollow all the way. Okay. Alright, so that's essentially where the snail's coming out of his shell right here. And they kind of come out and slime their way around. Alright, so now we're going to want a shell for him. So now, there's a couple different ways we could do it. I think I'm just gonna start with an easy one here. I'm gonna grab a sphere. Let's grab a sphere. So I'd say that looks pretty good. Alright, so now we're just gonna do them all in one material to start with, because most of his body here, we're gonna want the same material. So we're gonna click again on hill number 4, scroll all the way to the bottom, hold shift, click on sphere. Then we could scroll down here, go into materials. So now because I've been working on this map for a while, I have a bunch of custom materials up here. Normally when you go to materials, you're not going to see that. You're just going to start here at the core base materials. But since I have some custom ones made, let's see if any of these would be fun to put on them. So I kind of like that for his body. And I believe I might have used that already on some of the other snails, but we'll try and make his shell look a little different. Okay, so that looks pretty good. Unclick, use smart material here. So when you have smart material on, it chooses the U tiling and the B tiling for you. If you click it off, then you get to choose the tiling yourself. The reason we want to do it in this case is because we want all the pieces to look roughly the same, but because they're different sizes and different dimensions, the material is going to come out different. So, that looks good for his body. So now I'm going to want to try to match. Yeah, we'll just do the whole eyes here, so select all that. Now I was just starting with these balls. And sometimes on the materials you wanna watch how you're doing the tiling. So for instance, see how this looks nice and smooth. When you look at this island, it has this. I mean, you could use that to your advantage, I'm sure, depending on what you're making, but generally you don't want to leave a line like that, because it looks a little strange. Okay, so now, I'm probably going to want some different materials here. If any of you guys are curious what we're listening to, Legend of the Mystical Ninja Goemon from Nintendo 64. This is actually the second one that was only released in Japan. I was a big fan of the Super Nintendo game. That's why I looked up the soundtracks, and actually a bunch of the games have really, in my opinion, really good soundtracks. Or am I lying? I am Lion. It's Diddy Kong Racing we're listening to. This has the same feel as Mystical Ninja. So, Diddy Kong Racing, classic kart racing game that unfortunately got buried when Rare was bought out by Xbox. That ended that series. Now you notice when I switch the material here, now I don't have an option for smart material, and that really depends on the material. Most of them have the option, but then on some of the more special materials, it does not have that option. So, and for eyes, I like to do emissive. I mean, there's a lot. Probably more realistic, better ways to do those, but I kind of just like the way they flow. Kind of gives it a cartoon feel, which, if any, you know me, I'm a big cartoon fan, big comic fan. Anything with hand-drawn art, really, a lot of the time entices me, but it's not to say 3D art isn't good too. I mean, obviously enjoy doing it here, and of course, really shout out to them, because this is a great platform they've put together. And if any of you are not on Core or Epic Games platform, grab their browser, it's free. I know you guys are all stuck on Steam, and you have your achievements and your friends and all that, but it costs you nothing to get the browser, and there's free games constantly. I believe the free game right now is XCOM 2, and I think it was Insurmountable or something like that. It's like a rock climbing game, but I mean, a lot of the time, these are AAA games that they're giving out for free, which is insane. So yeah, I mean, I couldn't suggest more to people to at least get the browser. And even if you're not going to download the games right away, you can claim them for your account. And if you ever do want to play them, then they're there. You just have to download them, and away you go. Okay, so on to the shell. So now we got two parts here. Out of glass. So I like the glass little distortion. Alright, so now we're gonna want to copy paste these two Oldoid and Sphere. We're gonna switch the material. The reason I put the glass there, because I want a shiny kind of exterior, and then I'm going to shrink this down a little bit. I mean, that's kind of cool. You can deal cards in a casino or something with Snail. But that's a little much. But I might switch out this sphere for a different object. Let's see. One thing you could also do, I guess you guys probably can't see. So if you guys aren't able to see what the material is here, so you have a material picker that pops up here that shows you all the different materials. So sorry, I totally mind lapsed on that one. So if I was telling you guys about the custom materials up there at the top before you guys can see it, I do apologize. So right now I'm scrolling through the materials. If you move your material picker off to the side, that allows you to click on different materials and get a bit of a peek to see how it's going. want this pattern of material, but I don't want that color. So what I'm going to do is go down here. First I clicked on my custom thing. Now I have my material editor that popped up. So if you scroll down to advanced in your material editor, you'll see brighten albedo and desaturate your albedo. I don't know if I'm saying that right, but so desaturate. So what we're going to want to do is desaturate. Scroll it all the way to one on the other side. So that removes the color completely. I'm probably going to want a little bit brighter, so I'm going to brighten the albedo. Okay. Let's see, maybe we could give it a gradient too for fun. Usually you want to make your gradient darker of the two colors so that it shows up. So I'm going to pick a nice dark red here. Okay. Don't probably want it up that high, so I'm going to move it. Gradient shift down to like 0.2 and then up the fall off a little bit. I don't think I want quite that much gap between it and the gloss. This one a bit bigger. Okay, so I think that's kind of fun. It's shiny. I've got a little cartoon style snail here. So now we're gonna wanna make him into a merge model. So click hill, select it all, right click here in your hierarchy, new merge model contain these, and we're gonna go snail. Now I have a bunch of snails here, so I'm gonna see what I got. I have 7 of them, so I'm gonna go snail. And it's always important when you're building to label stuff properly. It's going to save you a lot of headache in the long run, I guarantee you that. So you could also go through and label here. So right now I'm going to grab his eyeballs. I'm going to go new group containing these. Mark his eyes. Shell, so I'm gonna go new group containing these. Shell. And this, I can just rename here, body. Now that way, if ever you want to edit it, so you click on snail, and you know, you can come in here, and if you want to just edit his eyes, you already have them in a group, and you don't have to think, oh, what's what, which. Because the other thing is, for example, I have it marked sphere here 3 times, you know, which one am I clicking on? And if you had all these in with everything else, then it's like that much more of a headache. Let's take a look at something else here on the map. So here's a turtle. So you can see here I have everything separated out. The shell, his head, his legs, I have each separate. this tab, and then you click on it. Mecha armor thigh. So for this turtle, I actually used a lot of mecha pieces that are meant to build robot mechs, but I repurposed it to do like a robot turtle. So, like here, this is a forearm, but you know, I've used it to make a neck. So yeah, what I could suggest to everybody is just take your time, play with the props, play with the different assets, the different basic shapes, and get in your head what's there and what shapes could do what. Because if you're resourceful and you know you have a good eye for it, you can make any piece into anything, really. You know what I mean? So it might say forearm, but doesn't mean you have to use it for a forearm. And the way I started, which I don't know if I suggest for everybody, but for the first maybe 2 months of building, I stayed completely in the basic shape area here. I didn't touch any of the props or tile sets really when I was building models. And part of the reason for that is, number one, you only have one area to search for. So I can show you here, look how big this area of props is. Imagine every time you want a piece, you're going through this whole section. Now obviously, if you know what section the piece you want is in particular, you could, you know, go over here and you have different categories, but it's not always obvious what piece you're going to want, you know, especially trying to figure out what works. So if you limit yourself to the basic shapes, you know, it's going to cost you some objects in your hierarchy. It's going to, you know, take more shapes than it would if you found a prop that maybe has a couple of the shapes in it that you want. But it cuts down on the searching through all the categories time, which, you know, when you want to build something and you just want to get through it, and you know, do more of a speed build, that's one way I suggest to do it. And then again, you could do something like this turtle where I used almost completely all props and there's very little basic shapes. Besides the shell here, I believe a half sphere. We've got a half pipe here. This is a bevel. It's showing half sphere, but it's a beveled ring. But yeah, like all the legs and the arms, the neck here, the head. These eyes are cylinders, pipes. But yeah. So what I did was stick to the mech area. So I could have found other, you know, different urban pipes and maybe military shapes that I could use. But I stuck to almost all mech parts, and then so you go down here in your categories. I forget where the mecha stuff is, but if you just search mecha, then you have all these robot pieces. And, you know, if you guys want to try building your own funny looking robots like this turtle here, I was able to do it with all these pieces here. I'll show you a couple other things. This crab here. Sorry if I'm saying I'm a lot. This map I designed for a survival type game that had like Hawaiian theme, ocean theme, and person I was working with was already pretty high on objects, so he wanted me to build some models, and he asked me to keep the object count low. So I'll show you this crab, which you probably couldn't get a lower count before. So here I'm clicked on the crab. And because it's an emerged model, for those of you that don't know what a merge model does, that cuts the number of objects down in runtime. So if ever you guys are having a hard time keeping under this object count, I mean, you should always be merging the models to begin with, but you know, if you've already built out your map and you have a bunch of stuff all over the place, you know, try to section stuff off. And the only time you want to merge stuff is when it's all in the same area and it's going to be seen mostly at the same time. You don't want to have stuff merged across the map because that's going to cause problems. But in tight areas, or like, you know, little models like this, like this crab, or your little coral thing here, the statue, you know what I mean? If somebody sees the statue, they're going to be seeing this whole statue at the same time, right? So to have it merged, completely makes sense. Alright, so now I'll show you quick here. The reason this crab is so low count, his body here is a forearm, a mecha forearm. Again, it's the same as the neck of the turtle. And you can see this, I guess this is like a little thruster thing that's normally on the side of the arm, and it just happened to work perfectly for his mouth. So if you figured, if you were going to build this out of basic objects, you would probably need at least one object for this, right? Two more pieces up here, and then at least one piece for the mouth, if not more. I mean, you wouldn't even get all these little details if you were doing it out of basic shapes. So out of this one piece, you got essentially multiple objects. And what's even crazier is this here. So for his legs, I use a mecha hand. Now, it's not perfect. I don't know how many legs crabs have. I believe they have six. So I'm actually, they have six, and then they have their claw arms. So, I mean, it's almost like they have eight, depending on how you want to look at it. And they are in the erector family. Anybody that's curious about crabs, I believe they are related to spiders, I think. I could be wrong, but I believe they are. So, that's, spiders have eight legs. So the two claw arms and six legs. So here he doesn't have the right amount because he has actually the thumbs that I'm also using as his arms or legs/legs. And the thumbs I put a pair of claws on for them. So I'm using that as his arms. And essentially, I don't even want to try and count how many basic objects that would have taken if you were going to build it that way. So definitely, you know, maybe I was doing myself a disservice by only building in basic shapes to begin with, because, I mean, how optimal is that, you know, that one hand object that counts as one object in your hierarchy that gave you all those shapes? So yeah, I mean, be resourceful, guys. We have a lot of toys in this toy box that they've given us. There's a lot more to come. Lots of updates constantly on here. I could say nothing but good things about the people that work at Core, the community on Discord, nice, even, you know. I've encountered very few disrespectful people. On the most part, people are here to have fun, to create together, you know. And I think that that says a lot, you know. I think we're building a good foundation here. So, you know, for starters here, I got guys. Showed you this little snail, how to build one of these. You know, I would say look forward to more episodes. You know, maybe we'll build some bigger things, some smaller things. I'll take you on a quick tour around the map here, just to give you guys an idea of things I've been working on. So, guys, this, the monkey head, I actually looked up. I don't know if any of you guys would be older if you know about this, but Secret of Monkey Island is a pretty old point-and-click series, and I believe they're coming out with a new game, I think this year, which is pretty exciting. I don't know if I'll get it or when I'll get it, but I really do like to see, you know, classics like that come back. I believe they have the original creator on board, so I think that's really awesome. You know, we're talking like 30 years since the first one was made, so it's, you know, it's awesome. Anyways, so got some snails here, some different vehicles. I made these snails into vehicles. This is like a inside here. I believe it's the cockpit from a sci-fi. So I repurposed that into a cockpit for the snail, which is essentially a cart. So if you go into your game components down here, you have a bunch of different vehicles, and you have your advanced cart, cargo cart, which is what I tend to use when I'm doing vehicles for whatever reason, because it's a one-seater, so it makes it a little bit easier to build with. You could also use cars and just restructure that. And I won't get into it too deep how you do that, but maybe another day we'll do a tutorial on how to build a vehicle and how to switch the shapes and restructure it. So here's a shark tank, a shark tank and a tank. It's a shark tank. Tongue twister team. Alright, so we got some killer whales, some different sharks. You can see some statues, different things I built here in the background. Some manta rays, dragonflies, some starfish. These starfish are five different shapes. I can show you guys actually quick how I built this. This is a pretty easy thing. So, for starters, you can see all each leg is a base of pepper. But what you're going to want to do is, the easiest way is to search it here. So just search star. And now, got some pre-made stars down here. Oh, star round, that might have worked nice too. Yeah, you could actually probably just use that for a starfish. That's only one shape. But what I did was I actually used the star bevel. And then I put my basic peppers over top, and I lined it up. I deleted that, and that leaves you with your nice star. So sometimes you gotta be creative to make yourself a template. Alright, and with that, I believe that'll be it for today, so. It's a nice little shot of an aquarium. So, for any of you newbies out there, welcome. Welcome to Core, welcome to my channel as well. Feel free to like, subscribe, and all that. Should have some more Let's Build episodes coming, so we'll do some more tutorials. At some point, we'll explore some different games from other creators, as well as maybe some of my own. I'm still learning myself. I've only had a course since November of last year, and I don't have any schooling for this, so if you guys are looking for professional tutorials, or more, something more advanced. Core has some good tutorials on YouTube. And the most helpful is get on Discord. The community there will help you out. And there's a lot of nice people on there. So, yeah, thanks for tuning in, and I wish everybody a great day, and until next time.